Hey, welcome back to Adobe Think Tank. Use hashtag Adobe TT to follow along and join the conversation. And I'm joined with David Kiron, executive editor at MIT Sloan Management Review. We were talking a little bit before we got on here about kind of the conference as a whole, your takeaways, and the disruption of industry with AI, but kind of talk to me about maybe what's relevant and what's not so relevant.
Yeah, so, I mean, there's a lot of talk here, there are a lot of vendors here.
Sure.
That are focused on chatbots, mm-hmm. and there's actually, there's a lot of value to be had from chatbots, but if you're talking about like changing industries, chatbots are not gonna be like the medium through which industries are gonna get revolutionized.
Right, it's like a base level, right? But so what can revolutionize industry, right? What gets you excited about AI as a whole?
If you take a step back and you think about AI in the context of like a number of large trends that are influencing industry and also society. It's not just industry. It's having like a really big effect right now on like four big industries. There's transportation, there's retail, healthcare, and finance.
Yeah.
But there are other trends. There's social media, there's 3D printing, there's climate change, there's demographic shifts underway. And the big effects, the biggest effects from AI are going to be seen from the interaction of AI with these other trends. And I'll give you an example.
Yeah.
There's, right now there's a big, in the public health space, there's a big problem with loneliness. It's such a big problem, it's affecting tens of millions of people around the world. And Britain just announced that, actually earlier this year, that they were appointing basically a minister of loneliness.
Which is a little job title you want to have, right?
Right, right. It's a little bit like the Monty Python sort of Ministry
right.
of Walks.
Yeah, it's a it almost sounds sarcastic in its sense. Yeah.
Yeah, but because it's such a real issue, it warrants that kind of a functional role in their government. But it's also in like reaching epidemic proportions in the U.S. Over 40% of the population of the U.S. is considered to be like lonely in some respects. Japan has been dealing with this for years and years and years. And AI actually has a real big potential to influence this through the creation of companion bots. And we don't actually have the institutional structures in place now to actually guide us in a given direction, in a socially optimal direction. And I think that's one of the big problems that we're facing now. Because AI can take us in so many different directions, we actually are right now at a point in time in our history, in the US, but also globally, where trust in institutions are at a low. But you need these institutions sort of to help guide us with like what's possible with AI.
Right, because AI is human-based. It can be programmed however you want to do with it. It can make you feel more connected, more disconnected. It's interesting you talk, though, about AI making people more connected, right? Because, I mean, there would probably be a popular feeling that you're like, well, this could make people more disconnected. It could kind of pull people away from the real world. Can it be used to connect people on a one-on-one level? Just, you know, I know, like, off-camera, somebody's playing around with my Tinder and Bumble right now because my phone's not here, but, you know, getting into that stuff.
Yeah, so AI does have the potential to connect people more in workplace situations. There's an opportunity to do much more collaboration around the use of AI through sort of AI-driven tools that allow for more collaboration.
Yeah.
But in terms of the risks that come from having companion bots out in the world and it's solving one problem, it really does raise a whole bunch of issues around how human relationships are going to be sustained going forward.
How we can disconnect. And then kind of circling back to a business perspective, how can businesses kind of acknowledge this, understand this, and be more intentional about how they use AI to, you know, reach consumers?
Yeah, so one of the first things we try to tell businesses, and we've written about this, is that you need to sort of get a basic understanding of what AI can do for you.
Sure.
And that's actually, somebody came up to me yesterday and said, like, what's a good plan for like how to do AI in our business? And I said, well, you have to take a step back from that and think about like, how are you going about thinking about what your plan is? Like, you need to develop like a plan for for creating a plan, and that means getting more educated about what AI can do for you.
Yeah.
And that oftentimes means developing a better sense of what data you have, what data you might need, and a better understanding of sort of how to rethink what your main business problems are and what the opportunities are for you through an AI lens.
And you mentioned, you know, those four industries. Automotive gets talked about a lot. That's an obvious one. The healthcare one, I think, is the growing one too, because not only are we getting into, you know, deep levels of diagnostics, but we're also doing simple things that make the process more efficient. So even going to the hospital becomes more human, more efficient. Maybe you're there for 30 minutes rather than 12 hours, and that's a better feeling, that's a better customer experience, right? So AI can be used a lot to create better customer experience in those kind of those four industries we're talking about.
Yeah, that's one of the things that we find that the organizations that are best at like doing customer engagement are using AI a lot more than other companies.
Sure.
And one of the ways this is happening is that there's all these different ways of understanding your customer now with the with different kinds of data sets. And the best companies for doing customer engagement actually are able to sort of bring these data sets together with machine learning to get a sort of a single view of what the customer is.
That's awesome. That's it? That's all we had to do? Hey, dude, I appreciate it. And hey, thanks so much for joining us. And go to AdobeThinkTank.com to learn more about this.